Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll take a look at how to make a cool fly-through window transition and we'll do everything in Final Cut Pro. Now, there is plugins out there that make doing this both easier and faster, but most of them cost money. If you don't have or just don't want to spend money on plugins, this is how you can do this with the tools included in Final Cut Pro. Just like any other transition, first thing you need is two clips in your timeline. The first clip needs to have a window or something similar to fly through. It also helps if there's no camera movement in the first clip. Place your playhead between your two clips and go back about 30 frames or so. Select your first clip and press Command B to blade it. Select the middle part and drag it up above your timeline, making sure to line it up with the start of your second clip. Open the effects browser, select the draw mask, and drag and drop it over your top clip. Zoom in on your viewer window and add control points to the inside of the window. Click on the first control point to close the mask. Over in the inspector, select the Invert Mask checkbox, and if needed, adjust the feather slider to soften the sharp edges of your mask. You should have your top clip visible, with the bottom clip only shown through the cutout in your mask. Next, let's zoom in on our top clip. For this, I prefer using the crop tool. Move your playhead to the start of your top clip, make sure it's selected, and from the drop-down menu, select the crop tool and make sure crop is selected. Add a keyframe here by clicking the little diamond button in the top left corner. Move your playhead ahead about 10 frames and use one of the corner handles to adjust the size of the crop box. Click and drag anywhere inside the box to position it over your window and make it small enough to completely fit inside. You might need to zoom in on your viewer for this. If your window is small, like mine, when using the on-screen controls, you'll notice that there's a limit on how small you can go. To make the crop box smaller, go to the video inspector, and in the crop section, click and drag the numbers to the right of the sliders to make the crop box even smaller. If you find it hard to be precise by dragging, hold down the Option key. This will let you make adjustments in smaller increments. Once your crop box is completely inside the window, click Done, and from the View drop-down menu, select Fit to see your whole clip again. Here's what we have so far. Let's clean this up a bit. First thing we need to deal with is a hard jump cut in the window. Place your playhead at the start of your top clip, make sure it's selected, and press Ctrl V to bring up video animation where we can see the crop keyframes. Move your playhead to about halfway between keyframes, and in the inspector, bring the fill opacity of the draw mask all the way down. Add a keyframe. Move the playhead about 5 frames past the last crop keyframe, and bring the opacity slider all the way up. Now, instead of a hard jump cut, we have a nice smooth fade between what we see in the window. Next, let's change and animate the scale of our bottom clip. Move your playhead to the first crop keyframe, select the bottom clip, and from the drop-down menu, select the Transform tool. Use the on-screen controls to bring down the scale of your bottom clip. You won't see the actual clip at this point, so just use the wireframe for reference. Position it over the window and bring down the scale until it's slightly larger than the window itself. Add a keyframe. Move your playhead to the last crop keyframe, and in the inspector, change the Transform scale back to 100%, and the X and the Y position values back to 0. In the viewer, right-click on each keyframe and change the motion type from smooth to linear to better match a crop animation. It won't match up perfectly, but this is as good as it gets in Final Cut Pro. And last, to bring this all together, let's add some sound design to this transition. Open the audio sidebar, and in the top right corner, search for a whoosh sound effect. Find one that best suits your clip and add it below your timeline. Here's our finished result. So, as you can see, effects like this do take a bit of time, but are still fairly simple. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more effects like this, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.